this is my cat, Metric. I got him. He's the reason I learned to code. I got him for two reasons. He's adorable, and I had a rat infestation in my apartment. So, given that, I can't really complain that he turned out to be a pitiless, unrelenting serial killer. He's brought in one animal every 10 nights. 3 a.m. is his favorite time. I tricked him with a fake rat here. Sometimes the animals he brings in are dead. Sometimes they're just badly wounded, in which case I have to euthanize a small animal in the middle of the night and try to go back to sleep. This behavior has also on one occasion brought an immediate and upsetting end to sex. Now, I'm not the only one who has this problem. There's 74 million house cats in the United States, and there's about 4 million hunters. So there's 4 million cats out there right now hunting down fresh horrors and bringing them home. So you'd think that there'd be solutions out there for this, but there kind of aren't. I can't keep a collar on my cat, so anti-hunting collars with bells or frilly colors won't work. People online say lock him out all night. I'm way too neurotic for that. I'd be freaking out if I did that. I could lock him in all night, but this cat poops exclusively outside. I barely have to clean his litter box. That's a lot of talent to let go to waste. So what I needed was something that didn't exist yet. I needed a cat door that would lock selectively when my cat was trying to bring in prey. Now, the locking part is easy. I used an Arduino, which is an electronics kit for dummies, and I attach it to a lock. The hard part is detection. How to tell when my cat is coming in normally or when it's murder cat Metric trying to ruin my night. To do this, I used the hottest new tech in image processing, machine learning. Machine learning works through lots of examples. You want a llama detector, you give it lots of pictures of llamas, it learns the shape and contour and colors of a llama, and pretty soon, it's gonna be able to pick a llama out of a lineup. I have no idea how it does this, I just know how to make it work. So I wanted to use machine learning, and I bought a camera specifically for that, the Amazon Deep Lens camera. I mounted it above my cat door. Takes about 2 seconds for the cat to go up the ramp, so all this detection needs to happen in less than 1 second to really make it work. So I spent several months gathering and hand-labeling over 23,000 images of my cat coming and going. I'm like the tech bro version of a crazy cat lady. So I fed all these images to an online machine learning service called SageMaker, and I created 3 models that I strung together to achieve the detection that I needed. The first model, stage 1, just runs all day long and it asks, is there a cat? Is there a cat? If there is a cat, it calls up stage 2. Stage 2 says, is the cat coming or going? It's pretty simple. If the cat is coming, then it's the moment of truth. It calls up stage 3, and that is the cat coming in normally? Or is the cat coming in to ruin my night? If the cat is coming in with prey, 3 things happen. First of all, it locks the cat door for 15 minutes, which is long enough. Second of all, it texts me pics. And third of all, it donates blood money to the Audubon Society. So this has been running for 5 weeks now. He's entered innocently 180 times and been unfairly locked out once. He's tried to bring in animals 6 times and been blocked 5. That's actually outdated. He got a new one. I got a new one. So for now, this just works with my cat in my house, but if I got more images, I could generalize it. So email me if you have this problem. And I can sleep through the night, which was my goal. My other goal was to learn, and I definitely did learn. It's much easier to learn this stuff if you have generous experts to help you. None were more generous than Jacob, who told me when I said I want to hire an engineer to code this for me, just said, learn to code yourself, I'll help you. And I did, and I'm so glad I did. And finally, I have to thank Metric, who every time my motivation was kind of getting low, he brought in a fresh, horrifying thing and got me right back up there. So thank you, Metric.
Thank you.